This is a beautiful little Hi8 video deck from Japan. It's a Toshiba model E-700BS, and as you can see, it's currently happily playing a tape. And all the transport functions and everything work fine. I've made recordings on it, and it's working absolutely fine. But there's a couple of reasons I want to have a little look inside it, and if I reposition the camera, I'll show you why. Now, eagle-eyed viewers may be able to spot both of the problems from this shot, but if I eject the tape, you can see that's absolutely fine, and we can load it, and it loads up fine. But the only reason that's happening is because this impedance roller here is stuck in that position. It should really be over there, but it's all kind of gummed up with old grease. If I start playing in that position, you probably can't see on the video, but that is actually now turning, as it should. And if I eject the tape now, it will just about manage to push that out of the way to get the tape out. Let's try that. It struggles, but it manages to push that out of the way, but it stays there. That should have moved back in. If I manually push it back in, where it should actually sit under its spring pressure, the tape won't load. Just gets jammed up, and I have to push that out of the way manually. So that's one problem, but I'm not really too worried about that. I can deal with that at my leisure. The more pressing problem is over here on the circuit board. That there is a memory backup capacitor. It's 0.047 farads, and as you can see from the top, it has already started to deteriorate, and I'm very worried that that is going to start leaking and do some serious damage to the circuit board. So my priority today is get that capacitor out. I'm not even going to bother to put a new one in because I don't think it really does anything useful anymore. But that capacitor has got to come out. Now, unfortunately, if I flip the machine over, actually, I'll take the tape out and power it down first. Power off. And completely power off. If I flip it over, I've already removed the bottom screening plate from the unit, so we can see as much as we're going to see of the underneath the circuit board, and as you can see, that isn't much really. They've given access holes to some parts, but unfortunately that memory backup capacitor is just here behind this piece of plastic. And if we look at the top of the board, to get in from the top, we'd have to remove the deck and get this main circuit board out. That is a big job, and I really don't want to do that. So my plan is, if I flip it back over again, is to try and cut away some of this plastic here so I can get at the capacitor and remove it without having to take the whole circuit board out. Now, although there is quite a bit of clearance between this plastic and the bottom of the board, I really don't want to cut that with a blade, just in case I go through and do some damage to the board. So my plan is to heat up a razor blade or something to red hot on the hob, and then I can melt, hopefully, through this plastic. It doesn't matter if the blade just goes through and touches the board, because it won't be hot enough to do any damage. And of course, if the plastic gets on the board, that's insulating anyway, so that doesn't matter. So that's what I'm going to try and do. So I'll have to adjourn to the kitchen in order to achieve that, because that is obviously where the cooker is. I'm going to try using a section of one of these snap-off knives. See if that works. Right, sorry about the noise. I've got the extractor fan going because I don't want to breathe in any of the fumes from the melting plastic. I know you can get a tool to do this. I think it's called a rope cutter, but I don't own one of those, and it wouldn't really be worth buying one just to do this one job, so I'm just improvising with what I've got to hand. Smaller bit of blade to go across this section here to heat that up in the flame. Yes. Now the big question is, does that give us access to the capacitor? Not quite enough. I think I just want a little bit more off here. Let's try with the smaller blade again. Right. Ooh. That's enough. Right, back to the workshop. There it is. Doesn't look as though it's quite started to leak from the bottom yet, but hopefully removing that has averted a potential future major catastrophe. And the board looks fine, so let's reassemble it. Working fine. So you could argue that was a complete waste of time really, because the machine was working before and it's still working now, but hopefully what we have done by removing this capacitor is averted a future catastrophe. And of course I still have the problem of what to do about this impedance roller. If you've got any suggestions, let me know in the comments. Thanks very much for watching.